Welcome back to the show. Well, he's a well-known character to London's gay community, and Catou joins me now in studio to tell us all about an upcoming fundraiser at Club 81 downtown London. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
It's great to have you here. A couple things we'll talk about today in just a moment here, but London's gay community, tell us your thoughts on London's gay community.
Well, it's diverse. I mean, you have parts of the gay community that don't really come out very often at all. They prefer house parties, but when Pride or something like that comes along, they're more supportive and more people come out. Mm-hmm. There's usually the same people that come out, the same to Club 181, to the bar scene, and right now there's only Club 181. They're very supportive, I have to say, of all my fundraising, and they're just as diverse as any other. Some of them would rather a little change in music, some of them don't want it, but you know, they're very inviting.
Let's talk, because that's why you're here today, to talk about a couple fundraisers. We have two different ones we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about Angels in America first, okay? And that will be November 24th, that is this Friday night. Mm-hmm. And it's taking place at the Wolf Performance Hall at the library. Tell us all about it.
Well, last year, John Gary and Fountainhead Productions put on Angels in America, and I was in it. I played the part of Belize. Thanks to Jonathan Bancroft, who helped push me this way. It went over very well, and I've got a lot of positive feedback. People have been very kind, very playful with it. So when he asked me, would you do the reading this year at Wolf Performance Hall, I said yes. It took a moment or two, but
let's just go back a little bit, just so people are on the same page. Tell us what it is, first off.
Okay. Angels in America is based on the time of about early to mid-1980s, when the gay society was dealing with the AIDS epidemic and everybody else wasn't. There was a lot of blind awareness, a lot of people weren't, they were putting blame on, saying, well, it was just the gay community or hemophiliacs and prostitutes. But it was more on the inactivity of how people didn't deal with it. And what this shows is how it affected all sorts of people's lives, from the nurse to, you know, friends, family. It's also a little bit of political charging inside of it.
Okay, so now the second one is what's going to happen Friday. So what will that be?
Well, that is going to be a reading. We're not putting, John is not putting on the whole production. Fountainhead is doing a reading. It's a benefit, memory serves me correctly, for the AIDS Committee.
Okay.
And it is going to be all the same characters, and we're just going to read the second part of the play.
Nice.
And it is a little nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm getting,
well, because when you're reading, you're out there. It's you're there.
I'm out there.
You're
anyway
doing it. Yeah, you're, I know, that's nothing. Hey, you already been out there. Okay, so then we're going to move on to Saturday, December the 2nd. There's another one on Saturday, December 16th. I'm gonna let our camera get a shot on this as we're getting a shot. Tell us all about this fundraiser.
Well, this fundraiser is a dual fundraiser. We're doing at Club 81, we're doing one for the St. Leonard Society and for our Christmas family. We've decided to amalgamate the whole thing, and we're going to do two different shows. We have some prizes and gifts, and we get a lot of positive feedback from the community. Some of the members are donating anything from like cans of soup, products, things for children. So we are also taking that gift certificates. I've had a lot of businesses offer to help me out. So we do this every year, and last year we did a Christmas family and the year before. So we're going to stick with that program.
Which means what, the Christmas family? Tell us what the Christmas family is.
We found somebody, I didn't do it, but I have two friends that found a family in need with a little bit of crisis in their life, and we've decided that until this family is a little more stable and up on their feet, a lady with six children, we are going to keep this as our Christmas family and do what we can to help. The children last year wrote some very heartwarming notes, as they did the previous year, thanking us for things like socks and school utensils, and the one girl, she requested a scarf. We were quite touched with that, and it almost brought you to tears.
Yeah.
The mother is very humbled, and we've told people we're not going to bring her to the show. We're not going to have her sit there because it could be embarrassing and a little problematic for her.
And they're not there for that. It's very behind the scenes. It's not a freak show.
The idea is to help. I mean, the idea is to put out the best that you can do to help someone else and add a little fun and entertainment at the same time.
Look at these great sponsors on here, mm-hmm. right? Ginger's Hair, Tribal Mountain, the Braywick Bistro, Nichols & Company, the Old South Market, Curiosity Gift Shop, Village Harvest, the Vogue Salons, Good Life, Passion for Beauty, Cafe One, Kiss the Cook, Prince Albert's Diner, Steel Magnolias. A lot of people come on
Funky
board.
Funky Monkey. On Richmond Street.
Yeah.
I'm getting a lot of support, and I have a lot of people in the community. And I'm very thankful. They trust my name, they work well with me, and they encourage me, and they will bring me pretty much what I'm asking for.
Great.
So it's a humbling experience, and it's a way to serve the community. And I'm thankful to God for what I have, so why not share?
Why not? The Funky Monkey folks are on the show tomorrow, which we love them too. It's great. Again, the two dates, December the 2nd, Saturday, December 16th. More info, you can just swing on by Club 181.
Yes, and they do have a website, club181www.com.ca.
Okay, we'll get it. Google. It's a pleasure to meet you, and in my dealings with the gay community, there's two things I'll always associate with. Very generous.
Yes.
And very friendly, slash okay. But know how to party. Like, there's no tomorrow.
Yeah.
I think that
6-inch stiletto boots help out marvelously.
You know, here's the thing. I always get a kick out of this big conservative London word, which I hate and never utter myself. But the thing is, if you want to get unconservative, stop by and party with the crew over there. It'll change your life.
We have a lot of straight individuals that come in. They've been their wife, their girlfriend, their boyfriend. One man asked me, he says, well, what goes on there? And I said, what do you think we do? Fleeing from chandeliers with feather boas, having sex all strung out on pot? No.
You're partying.
It's a bar, a lovely party scene, and the bar owners and managers often traipse throughout the city to pick up all the things that I need, and George puts the bill for the lighting and everything else.
Yeah.
So,
good times.
A very dedicated community.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Many blessings much to them.
Yeah, and we will have an email up at the end of the show in case you missed any of that. We'll have more of the show coming up next.